I'm all for a body transformation, but apparently, going through puberty, editing your photos until you look like a demon from the depths of hell, and moving ludicrous amounts of weight is gobbled up by people who are hungry for some content. They don't know any better though. I don't blame them. They actually haven't seen good content yet, so they settle for mediocrity and cringiness. You see, it's hard to compete against all the freakazoids lumbering around in the gyms and spreading on social media like wildfire. Instead of carving your own path, why not join them? So there's going to be three things I'm covering in this video. His progression, his program, and his content. But first, let's talk about his progression. Specifically, Ryan's bench press progression. But before we start the progression, we have to start with a timeline. Ryan Casey has been lifting for 4 years. Noob gains are completely gone. 3 out of those 4 years, he focused on bodybuilding and hypertrophy. He ignored the compound movements, and he pretty much only chased a pump in the gym. I think bodybuilding is rather stupid, especially at such a young age, but besides that, impressive physique for a 16-year-old kid. So back in April, Ryan gets picked up by one of the most sought-after sponsorships in the fitness industry. No, I know what you're thinking, not Gymshark, Capri Sun. Capri Sun contains 100% juice, and this is where things get interesting. Also in April, Ryan heads down to Jersey, where he realizes that he is nowhere near the strength level of these burly boys. It's okay, Ryan, me too. So this is where we're gonna start analyzing his progression.
I am going for a max today. He thinks I'm gonna hit 275.
Go! Push it!
Push!
Get it!
I haven't even really done bench for like 2 years, 1.5 to 2 years. And last time I did, I tried for a 1 rep max, so I think I got 225.
So Ryan Casey has claimed to have bench pressed twice in his life. Twice. And he just rolls into the gym. Oh yeah, I'm gonna hit a 275. Apparently, the principle of specificity does not apply to Ryan Casey. So the first time he hits a 225, impressive, cool, whatever. Then he hits a 275. That's a 50-pound jump, and he hasn't even touched a barbell. Okay, maybe he goes through puberty, maybe he gets a little stronger, sure. We'll still give him the 275 bench. Nothing that out of the ordinary.
I don't normally bench.
So there are two things that could be going on. Either he doesn't admit to training certain exercises so that he could look cool and flex on camera, or he actually doesn't train the exercises and he defies physiology and motor neuron recruitment. So like I said in my last video, shoulders and traps are dead giveaways for people that use steroids. These areas have more androgen receptors, and when you take steroids, they blow up inside. So Ryan Casey's non-existent traps suddenly blow the fuck up out of nowhere, right around the same time that he releases his athlete program. That's the dumbest fucking name for a company. Athlete. That just doesn't roll off the tongue nice. Athlete. Holy fucking shit, I didn't know bench press trained your traps that much. Ryan, do you rack pull? Do you deadlift? Like, what are you doing for your traps, my guy? So now it's June, 2 months after he hit the 275 with the Jersey boys. Ryan is still at a 275 bench. He is not maxed out yet, but his working sets are with 205.
My max is 275, like you guys saw me doing in New Jersey, so I'm doing 205 for six.
6 months later, he's repping 315. All of a sudden, Ryan, at the ripe age of 17, benches 385 pounds. 385 pounds. 385 pounds! And by the time this video is out, maybe he's even benched 405. You guys realize how much weight that is, right? 17 years old. And it's not like he's even like using leverages to his advantage and like cheating on the bench press. His grip is narrow enough where it's like, holy fuck. He just benched 385. He's not doing some powerlifting cheat bench.
My shoulders are kind of not aligned. So if I was to use like a straight bar, it would kind of put it at a weird angle for me and I wouldn't, you know, grow.
So a few things are gonna happen. Either he's never gonna bench press this much weight in a while unless he jumps on cycle again, or he blasts and cruises and becomes the world's best bench presser at the age of 17. So he adds 110 pounds to his bench in 6 months. He is now benching more than Omar Issaf, who has been identified as a natty who's been training for years specifically to powerlifting. This type of progress is not attainable naturally. He goes on a simple bulk of 10 to 15 pounds and now looks like an absolute gorilla and toys with weight like it's his bitch. So Ryan comes out with his power building program because, you know, that's a word these days. Whatever happened to just, I like the gym, I like to look good, I like to feel good. Ryan is not a certified personal trainer. He's never made programs before this athlete company. It's not a smart idea to take lifting advice from someone that's 17 years old and has only been properly strength training for the past year. You see, everything's gotta turn into this schemey, slimy business these days. 30% off if you use this discount code. Trust me guys, my program works. I applaud you. It's a very interesting way to telling people to wire money from their bank account into yours. And in return, they get a bundle of dumb fucking information with your mushroom stamp logo, RC Aesthetics, stamped on it. I mean, I don't entirely blame you though. It's a common trend for YouTubers to sideline school and pursue other things to make money at the time. When everything is on the line, you're gonna take every single edge that you can get so that you can succeed in the business. You're telling me Ryan is the only guy in this picture not on steroids? This is the sales team of Athlete. Ryan does have a very nice following, but how can we sell his programs? He's not as ripped as Andre or as big as Brandon Harding. He doesn't have a butt like these Instagram girls. I got it. Power building. But there's a problem, Ryan. You only bench 275 pounds. Do you think you could get that up to 385 in 6 months? Oh yeah, get right on it. Stop tossing around these dumb words like power building and just realize that it's focusing on compound movements and then getting a pump in the gym. Once again, I have no problem with people taking steroids. However, I have a problem with the principle of using your body as an image and a selling point so that people will buy your program. Because when you make a program, you're guaranteeing people results, and they are not going to get the results that you are getting.
We got some people killing it on my program. Jay, 3 weeks ago, his bench max was 235. Now, literally 3 weeks into the program, he's benching 225 for 10, like easy.
Did you guys just hear that? 235 for a single turns into 225 for 10 within 3 weeks. Okay. I swear to God, he's pulling these numbers out of thin air.
His squat, 300 to 375 in 3 weeks. It's insane.
By the way, posting about how well your program works based on Instagram DMs from inexperienced lifters shows me that you want to use their progress as social proof just to sell more products and make more money. When in reality, anyone misinformed enough to follow you and your bullshit has never touched a barbell in their life, and no shit they're gonna make gains when all they've done is ignore legs and train biceps. A cross-section of your 12-year-old audience that claims that you're this program god and that you've developed all these secrets to increasing strength, meanwhile you've only been seriously lifting for the past year, proves absolutely nothing. Content. Jesus Christ, this guy's content.
Before this video starts, I kinda just wanna give a little warning. Basically, a few of my camera settings changed while in the middle of like filming this vlog throughout the few days that I was.
Hey guys, sorry for this really shitty video, but just stick around and enjoy.
Basically, some of the footage is gonna be like really, really whack. Like obviously, you're still gonna be able to watch.
How are you this lazy as a content creator? I actually had to sift through piles of shit just to find the clips to use for this video. You see, I wouldn't be that mad. You guys are probably thinking, Phil, is it that bad? Is this content really that bad? I've never really watched any of his videos. Let me just leave you with this. Okay? Okay, this is Ryan Casey content. Hey guys, sorry, I'm way too lazy to actually make a video 10 minutes long, and I want to get all the ad revenue I can, because that'll increase my subscribers, so buy my programs. What is this horse mask stuff?
Oh, they've got an exhaust too.
Stuff, like what? How is this fun? Why do people subscribe to this? What is this horse mask? Everyone is natural, you're not training hard enough, and you don't have the genetics that they do. You're just shitty. No. No. No!